بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear viewers in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. In today's program about the parables of the Quran, we are going to take a very, very beautiful parable from Surah Ibrahim. The parable of the true world, the goodly world, and the parable of an evil world. Let us take the ayah first, that is ayah verse number 24 of Surah Ibrahim, which is number 14 in Al-Quran. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ألم تر كيف ضرب الله مثلا كلمة طيبة كشجرة طيبة أصلها ثابت وفرعها في السماء تؤتي أكلها كل حين بإذن ربها ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس لعلهم يتذكرون ومثل كلمة خبيثة كشجرة خبيثة اجتثت من فوق الأرض ما لها من قرار يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء ألم ترى كيف ضرب الله مثلا كلمة طيبة. Don't you see how Allah sets forth a parable of a goodly word like a goodly tree whose roots is firmly fixed and its branches reach to the heavens. It brings forth its fruits all times by the leave of its Lord. So Allah sets forth parables for men in order that they may receive admonition. And the parable of an evil word is that of an evil tree. It is torn up by the root from the surface of the earth. It has no stability. Now, before we proceed to the next ayah, let us take these two ayat. What is the parable itself? The parable of good word. What is the good word? What is the best word? The good word is the words of La ilaha illallah, kalimatu tawheed. There is none to be worshipped except Allah. That is the best words. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, أفضل ما قلته والنبيون من قبلي لا إله إلا الله وحده. So لا إله إلا الله, that is the best word. And the example of that word is just like شجرة طيبة, like a very good tree. أصلها ثابت, the root of that tree is very deep in the land. وفرعها في السماء, and the branches going to the heaven. تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا كُلَّ حِينٍ بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهَا, and it gives its fruit at each and every time with the permission of its Lord. That is the parable which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given for the people so that they can think and ponder deep into it. Now, who says La ilaha illallah? A Muslim, a believer. Now, if you take the example of the tree, which tree could be mentioned in this parable? Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam once was asking the companions, "Tell me about a tree, the leaves of which do not fall in any season, and that tree resembles a Muslim, Muslim who says La ilaha illallah." Now the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started thinking about different trees. Abdullah ibn Umar, who was a young lad at that time, he said to himself that it should be the palm tree. But because the elders were sitting there, he could not say it. Now, nobody has spoken about the palm tree. Everybody was saying about something else. So the Prophet ﷺ told them that this is the palm tree, which resembles the believer. Abdullah ibn Umar was very satisfied, was very happy. When he came back home, he said to his father Umar that, "I thought about that dead tree." And Umar said, "Why did not you say it?" He said, "Because I was shy of speaking in front of all these elders." And Sayyidina Umar said, "If you have said it, oh, it was so pleasing to me." Anyhow, in this example, even the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is saying that the palm tree resembles the Muslim. How? That the palm tree or the date tree is beneficial in everything. The fruit of it, of course, there are so many types of dates. There are fresh dates, there are dry dates, there are in between, they are of different colors. Even when it dries up completely, still it is edible and it can be stored as well. So the fruit is taken. What about the leaves and the branches? The leaves and the branches are used in many ways. Some people, they make basket out of them. Then even just think about the primitive mosque which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has built in Medina. The roof of that mosque was of what? Leaves and branches of the tree, of the palm tree. Even the stem of the palm tree, it is used as a pillar. The pillars of the mosque of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was none except these palm trees. And then we also know that even the animals, they are fed up on these leaves and other materials which is taken from the tree itself. Even the stone inside a date, when it is crushed, and then it is used as a food for the animals. The tree itself is very shady. It gives shades to people, it gives shades to the animals. So in whatever way you think about the palm tree, it is useful. So is the example of the Muslim. A Muslim is always useful, beneficial to others. Now just think that the tree itself, when it is very deep rooted in the land, it means that it is very firm in the land. How the tree is going to give you fruits? When it takes its food from the land itself. So if the tree, if you want a lot of fruit from a tree, then you must think that this tree is getting good food from the soil, from the land itself. And the food does not come only from the soil. It comes from the atmosphere as well, from the air as well. The tree is taking its food from both sides. And this is the example of the believer as well. He is taking his food, that is the spiritual food, from his own nafs. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed taqwa in his own nafs. The saying of La ilaha illallah, or the recognition of La ilaha illallah, is always hidden in his own nafs. So when he follows La ilaha illallah, that is the inner cry of his soul. So he benefits. He benefits from his own nafs, and then he benefits from the external evidences. That is the evidences of Al-Quran. Evidences which are scattered in this universe. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about nafs, وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ أَفَلَا يُبْصِرُونَ. Don't they think about their own nafs? And in the same way, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows His signs in the universe. So just like a tree which is taking its food from both ways, in the same way a believer is taking his food from his nafs and from outside, and these are the messages of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala scattered in the universe. Now in contrast comes the evil words. What is the evil words? The evil word is the word of shirk. The word when you associate deities with Allah, that is the evil words. Now the evil words example is just like a thorny bush. Now that thorny bush, which is just on the surface of the earth, it got no roots in the land. It can be uprooted at any time. And in the same way, it is not beneficial. It is thorny. It is injurious. It is not going to benefit anybody at all. It is sour. Even the fruit, if there is any fruit, it is very sour and bitter. So that is the example of the evil words, the word of shirk. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is why He said about the evil word, وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ كَشَدَرَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ اشْتُصَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ. The example of the evil word is just like the evil tree, which is going to be uprooted very easily. It can be uprooted from the surface of the earth. وَمَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ. It got no basis in the land at all. So this is how you differentiate between the two words, the word of Tawheed and the word of Shirk. Now coming back to this example of the palm tree, we said that it is useful in all ways, and we have given some example. It is a very, very fruitful type of food. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we read about his biography, and in which we come to know that sometime he said there was nothing to eat in Al-Madinah except for Al-Aswadan. Al-Aswadan. And by Al-Aswadan, two black things, he meant water and dates. Just water and dates. And they're eating the dates and drinking the water. That was their food. And they could survive. Because the food which is the dates themselves, they are very nourishing and very powerful. It gives strength to the body. And this is why a person can survive on that food. And we also said that this tree, which grows, the palm trees, it grows in the sand. So it does not need a lot of water. It takes little from the water, but it gives more. And that is the example of the Muslim. He does not expect a lot from the others, but he gives them more. He is beneficial a lot. Anyhow, inshallah, we are going to cover the next ayah, which is related to this subject, in our next episode. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Oh,